Hello everyone, welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. Myself Arvind Paliwal and I am here to explain about working of DC shunt motor. The DC shunt motor which we are using here has order code 69001. Move on to the introduction. DC motors are commonly used in industrial machinery because of their inherent advantages, good speed control, high starting torque. So, definition. The shunt motor is different from the series motor in that field winding is connected in parallel with the armature instead of in series. You should remember from basic electrical theory that a parallel circuit is often referred to as a shunt. Since the field winding is placed in parallel with armature, it is called as shunt winding and the motor is called as shunt motor. Now let's move on to the construction and technical working of this motor. The motor here which we are using has specifications 750 watt DC shunt motor, 1 horsepower, armature winding 180 volt, field 220 volt and 1500 rpm. Terminal indications, 2 terminals for field excitation F1 and F2, 2 terminals for armature A1 and A2. So some technical description of this motor. The main frame yoke of this machine is made up of high permeability rolled steel. The stator and rotor core are built of low loss silicon steel lamination. Commutators are made from copper. Enameled copper conductors are used for armature and field windings. Armature and stator windings are impregnated on high dielectric strength thermosetting varnish and are cured to render them immune from moisture, acid and alkalis. The working principle of this DC motor is when a current carrying conductor is placed in a magnetic field, it experiences a mechanical force whose direction is given by Fleming's left hand rule. It is run in two operation modes. First is self excited mode and the second is operation in separately excited mode. Here we are using a variac and a DC supply for this experiment. Firstly, we are operating it in self excited mode. So we will supply from variac to input AC of DC supply box. Now we will connect output of DC to A1 and second terminal of DC to A2. As we are using it in self excited mode, we will short F1 terminal to A1 terminal and F2 terminal to A2 terminal. In this condition, as voltage is applied across the two terminals A1 and A2, the motor rotates. So now we will variac. You can see the motor rotating. Now when we will supply it with 230 volt DC, it will run on its maximum power, that's 1500 rpm. You can see now it's near 220 volt DC. So now it's running on its maximum power, that is 1500 rpm. For separately excited mode, we will apply fixed DC voltage 230 DC volt to the F1 and F2 terminals. So for this, we will connect it from DC. So we will give it input AC to DC supply box and we will take out the output DC on F1 and F2 terminals. Now for variable at A1 and A2, we will take supply from variac. Now we will get input from variac and output to A1 and second terminal of output DC to A2. This is our separately excited operation. Now when we will operate the variac, and take it to 220 volt DC. You can see the motor speed rising. Now, as you can see in multimeter, that it's reached 230 volt DC. Now, this motor is running at 1500 RPM, which is its maximum RPM. Now, with this, we end our experiment upon this DC shunt motor. If you like the video, please like, share, and subscribe.